Before the launch, a cleaning exercise was first conducted along the shores of Lake Victoria following the alarming garbage disposal that caught the attention of environmental activists. Residents have been told to desist from careless disposal of filth in the lake, keeping in mind the devastating effects it has on fish. Minister for Relief, Disaster Preparedness and Refugees Hilary Onek has directed the police to work hand in hand with environment conservation organizations and fight the continuous practice of improper disposal of garbage.
There are quite a number. One, it has an impact on the fish products that we receive from the back, that we get, and also to human health. So it's very important that we keep the place very clean, but we also need to ensure that we work with legal institutions and enforcement agencies to stop this illegal activity.
Officials from Uganda Junior Rangers highlighted some of the dangers brought about by deforestation and the negative impacts that are associated with improper disposal of filth in the lake. We have been sensitizing masses not to dispose of plastics in the lake and to also stop cutting down trees and conserve nature. This affects water quality, bad smoke affects people's health, a reason why we have given out free gas cylinders and water purifiers. Some of the fishermen and vendors at Port Bell, however, noted that garbage that is in the lake increases during the rainy seasons. We ask the government to intervene and help us because we are unable to clean the lake. It also threatens away customers. Garbage threatens away fish in the lake, which badly affects the fishing activities. We no longer get enough fish because of too much debris within the lake. We ask the government to come to our rescue. It has tarnished our reputation, especially before people who come here for touring. They presume that we dispose of garbage in the lake carelessly, yet we do not. The Nakawa East Member of Parliament, Engineer Ronald Malimwezo, sided with the fishers' call, prompting the government's intervention to save people's lives at the face of this calamity. He cautioned residents who received gas cylinders to prioritize learning how to use them first.
Majority of you are going to get gas cylinders. Gas today is a blessing, but if you don't learn how to use gas, it may become a curse. And therefore, I request all of you to learn how to use gas so that it may not become a curse in your home. Recently, there is a young lady who procured a gas cylinder and gas burnt her completely. Therefore, I caution you to make sure that you learn how to use gas. Take time before even you start using it to learn how to use it. Otherwise, you may destroy your life and all the property that you have in your house because of lack of knowledge on how to use gas.
Whatever waste doesn't go into landfills or other disposal areas usually finds its way into the ocean or other bodies of water, which not only slowly contaminates the water, but also chokes out life in the water.